original woodwork in there, and you know, it hasn't basically been significantly renovated since its inception, which is when we put on the National Registry.
That's a lot of snow.
Yeah. So I'm sorry, what was your name again?
I'm Dave.
Dave.
Okay. Dave Brewster.
Robin and Jean.
Yeah, I can tell the cars who just decided to leave for winter. They've got quite a bit of snow piled on them.
Yeah.
I have an old Volkswagen Westphalia bus. It's our pride and joy, and we absolutely love her, but we spent last winter in Anchorage, and we kept her running and occasionally put her on the road, but up here, by the time December hit, we winterized it and pulled the battery out, and she's sitting with her.
This is the most snow you've had this season, correct?
Yeah, so this is the snowiest year we've had in over a decade.
And, I thought Alaska, you have a lot of snow.
Yeah, coastal Alaska can get a ton. Some areas of the coast actually get such a buffer from the ocean that some years they don't retain much snow below 200 or 300 feet. They're usually on the hillsides, and other years. Somebody calling me? So when this was constructed, at the time it was the largest privately owned pipeline project in the world. Worked through both winters to construct it on time. And it was projected to cost $800 million, ended up costing $8 billion in the 70s. So you can imagine what the price tag would be like today. The metal that came over came in prefabricated sections.
Oh yeah, please. If you don't mind, that's very kind of you. Thank you. Yeah, you just hold that down just for a second or two. Thank you. Thank you.
There's probably a few up there.
And morning.
They are, like most deer species, really a species of edge. And at the, what you call, you refer to as ecotone, where two habitat types meet, usually have more of the shrubby type stuff than diesel fuel, but also food and supplies and all sorts of other pieces of heavy equipment to keep putting new oil rigs and new platforms in and maintain what they have up there.
Thank you. That's impressive.
Perfect light right now. Tough with something high and the snow is drowned out.
Yeah.
Watch yourself on the road.
Yeah, yeah.
Would you mind, sir? You're okay. I'm watching.
Oh, you are, thank you. Do you want me to get a picture of you?
Yes,
so
please.
See?
Yeah. It's kind of you. Thank you.
Are you ready?
Ready?
Yep.
Robin?
Thank you.
You want another one?
Oh, go on then.
Is it the band?
Okay. Awesome.
Okay. You want one of the sunset here?
Sure. Am I still in it? You are superb, thank you. Yeah. Okay, you ready? Just check that that's...
See what I mean by, you know, what it looks like for long periods without fire here. You would just have a sea of what you see in front of us, which is just black spruce. We do have white spruce that grows in a few areas in the interior. It's a slightly bigger tree, or has the potential to be bigger, and it's slightly more valuable as far as timber goes. But it's
like Christmas.
Looks like wax.
Station. They're only about 70 miles, so the same operations. You kind of shoot back and forth there.
Okay.
And a couple of the lodges that do mostly fishing and summer tours. You know, they help supplement the winter income a little bit by having a couple of the ski guides to go along with those folks and take them up the mountains. Yeah, if you've ever seen video of people skiing in Alaska and, you know, they get dropped off on this jackknife edge of a mountain where you can't land, you have to start skiing as soon as you come out of the, the helicopter. Those are the areas that I'm referring to. Yeah, I mean, if that was me, and I thought that he maybe had too many people to get, you know, safely back into town, and that's why I was going to suggest, you know, just coming up at the Yukon River Camp because it's so close. But once I sorted out that they could actually fit everybody in there, and then another guy pulled up.
Too. So, I mean, with the other vans, and this is a busy day, we'll probably see other vans all along the trip, and there's also a lot of truck traffic.
Okay.
So this is one of the best places during daylight hours to see moose through here, and out in that meadow especially, I just don't see any guys out and about today.
I don't see it. They would be black, right?
Yeah, dark brown. From this far away, it looked just kind of like a big dark spot. And, you know, they will be up and feeding this time of day, but often during the day, they kind of bed down and hunker down. Even a big 1,000-ton animal can be tough to see when it's like that. Some of the trees regenerate. The pipeline is designed to be able to endure fire, and they don't really do anything to suppress it around it. They just let the fire burn it over.
Wow.
You know, I've only been signed up for one of those, and because the tour leader from Costa Rica that was coordinating it had provided us the wrong time. I had to actually cancel that trip and somebody else pick them up. So I usually don't do the ice fishing trips, and that's primarily because it's so close to the boss's house and such an easy trip that it's easy to get one of the guides to do that. These long distance driving, there's only a few of us who will consistently agree to do these trips.
You didn't have to go over the tree.
I gotta say, I'm a little disappointed. I didn't grab my beads today. We'll go really, really slow. Don't worry.
Thank you.
It's about a quarter mile across, so we've got a long time.
Yeah. No one's behind us.
No.
They know the tour vans always go really slow through here anyway, so they're expecting it. You guys can even crack your door open and take photos out of it.
Better ice scraper. Now we can see.
We can see.
Look, this is a better ice cream.
There's a bunch of BLM outhouses scattered around here, and this is one of the coldest points in the trip usually. So before the Yukon River Camp would be open, y'all would have to go outside to be here. So
is this the camp
we're
stopping at?
Yeah, we're
going to
cram the lab.
So we can get pictures. A very wind-blown place, so this is one of the only sections of the road that has a lot of reflectors on the side of the road, because there's times you wouldn't see the edge of the road without them. Wow, yeah.
Figure Mountain is named after this little chunk of bedrock that sticks out of the ground just before the actual peak that kind of looks like a finger and points almost directly back to the south, southeast in the direction of Fairbanks.